Hello and welcome back to Tharic Plays Mordheim, City of the Damned. The Damned. Today we are going into our next story mission. I'm not 100% comfortable with our group setup, but I hope it'll work out fine and I would like to progress further here. And why should we always try to completely overlevel? That's what I'm getting at here. Our rating is not 1399. We need to advance one day right now. So we'll do that. And there we go. And I could switch in this zombie for somebody else, but that's probably not that big of a difference. It's just a little bit of higher stats, maybe. But that's about it. I also just realized that Lurch is already rank 6.5. I did not quite grasp that before, because we still have this room down here for I don't know what yet, actually. Possibly another hero, I think. Yeah, we need to double down there somewhere. We need to see who we get and what we get and what we want to bring there. But yeah, that's pretty much it. And I also will have to bring Uncle Fester, because we can't bring anybody else with this right now. So our heroes are a little bit on the weaker side. Zanda still can do stuff, but she's no longer as damage heavy as she used to be. But let's jump into our mission. We are at 1788 and it is 1600. So a clan of Redmen have infested the Quayside. Our plans of shipping the corpses to Sylvania must not be impeded. And we also need to get that totem, if you remember, but I'll guess we'll get the synopsis again now. So let's jump into it.
Mordheim is too uncertain a place to store the bodies of the Raven Guard commanders. There are too many who might make use of them, and setting a guard on their coffins has become burdensome. I have been in contact with Count Vlad, and in his wisdom, he has sent a ship to bear the coffins back to Sylvania. Even now, it waits on the River Stir. The vassal cannot dock, however. My spirit familiars have discovered the reason why. The Quayside is infested with Skaven, the pestiferous ratkin who long ago despoiled the palace of Nagash the Black, and who sought to cast down the haunted tower of Van Haldenschloss. And even again are these filthy beasts interfering in the ambitions of the aristocracy of Night. It is not enough that they steal every speck of weirdstone they can ferret from the runes. Now they deny transport of new servants for the master. The Skaven must be driven from the docks. The best way to settle the beasts is to overwhelm them with a show of force. Find the biggest rat and kill it. Then the others will lose heart and scurry back to their burrows like the cowards they are. While battling the Skaven, it would be wise to keep an eye out for an old shipwreck that is mentioned in the funerary records. It seems the captain and his mate were left in their ship rather than removed to the Garden of Moor. Their bodies might be as useful as those from the barracks. Vlad will need captains at sea as well as land. The Ratkin aren't without their own magic. The fog that stubbornly clings to the docks emanates from a totem the Skaven have erected. If we can secure that totem and set it on our ship, then it will be safe from the attentions of Stirland's River Wardens. There will be no fear of the warden seizing a ship hidden inside fog.
Okay. So I still think it's a pretty cool thing, but it probably flies above the heads of most people. Or it just sounds impressive. In the first half of all this, she talks about a lot of figures and places and stuff like that. And you need to know your Warhammer Fantasy lore to understand that. I know some of what she's talking about, but not nearly all. So it kind of gets lost on me. But I like what they do there. But I think for a lot of people it will not make sense if they're not familiar, because they don't know who Nagash is or all of this. Yeah. And also, as expected, we have three key objectives here, apparently. We need to kill a rat ogre, I assume, because that sounds like the biggest rat. Then we need to find some sea captain bodies, probably, something like that. The High Commander's coffin. No, that's the officers. The martyr's sarcophagus. No, also not. We need to locate the shipwreck. Oh, we actually need to go into the sewers. Oh, I dreaded that. So we need to do all of this. So, and then we need to find that Skaven totem that creates the fog, basically. Yeah, so. Baroness Katharina von Dansbach. There we go. I think... God, really? Everything? I cannot put everything on... We can actually put everything on her. I'm just gonna hope that's okay.
Objective complete.
And do that. And we already know that we need to go this way. So this is probably the sewers area. And it's not actually where we need to go right now. I'm considering how we want to approach this. We could go... I know this map, so I know where we need to go, I think. Yeah, we are right there. There should be an access to the sewers. Right here. I think, which means we need to go there. But let's see about this again. What does Van Hel's touch do? Restores up to 30 wounds. Okay, that's cool. She can heal now. Didn't she? I think she didn't use to do that in the beginning. But I would like to use Call of Van Hel on the zombies as per usual. And she can do that too. And I think she might have the mastered version of that. I'm not 100% on that. But she can do that a lot safer for the zombies than Uncle Fester can. So I'm okay with going for that. And I guess we just... Yeah, this is very, very foggy right now. Okay, so there's a Skaven there. There are multiple Skaven there. And down there should be the entrance to the sewer. So I think what we're gonna do is put ourselves in this building. Oh, actually that will give them too much vision. Okay, let's go here and set up an ambush. They still know where we are and they might come this way, but now I shouldn't be able to get surrounded as easily. And I hope she's not too far away for some of our important units to catch up there. Okay. Did not get our ambush, but at least we hit him. And we're okay. There's one more enemy that should be able to attack us, but not more. And this guy is not making any impact right now. I actually like the Quayside map. It's not very extraordinary or anything, but it's got multiple layers. It's got at least in one direction there's not much you can see. I'm missing the word here, because you have a lot of vision sideways basically, but not north southbound because there's the buildings in the way. But there are long streets from west to east, and that just very obviously dictates how this map, or what you can do on this map. And then you've got the waterfront and the ships and all that. It's I just like the way this map looks. It's a lot. I think it's the map that's closest to being a standard Mordheim mission map, basically. I guess that's what I'm trying to say. And I like that, because I like the normal maps. And, yeah, it's just... It's a thing. Oh, I can actually go for Rotten Touch. Let's do that. Let's... A little bit of damage might be all we need here. Do we want to do another one? 28%? That's okay. Nope. Failed the spell cast. And he does nothing. So, we're gonna go in an ambush stance right here. I assume more of them might come our way. The important thing about this right now is... Well, that was also a weird statement. I think more of them might come this way. More of them definitely will come this way. But what I was getting at, that for one, he can't move. And also we have Lurch back here who will definitely be able to cover all this area. Oh, good. He jumps up back here in an ambush stance. Okay, that looks like a hero. Yeah, okay, that was the Black Skaven. Do I want him to charge David? Yeah, apparently we do. Oh, crit stun. Well, that's kind of mean. That's kind of mean. Okay, we have two heroes and their leader. We don't see the leader yet, but we know he's close. And with Lurch being here and us having our entire warband there, I think we should be able to take those down quickly. The problem with this map usually isn't the guys that are on here, but it's that it takes fairly long, I think. For what you have to do on the map, and there's always gonna be enemies respawning. Okay, the leader is right there. And because of the multiple layers, there's gonna be ranged guys respawning, all those things, and that makes it difficult. I don't want to attack him here. We're gonna be alone against him. And I don't like that, so we're gonna bring Benjamin down here. I think, for one, Lurch I would be okay with, but I'm also okay with our leader probably going in there and attacking. Because then he has to check for terror and all that stuff. And that should help us quite a bit. Or make us able to deal with it. But a henchman versus... their leader is just not a good idea. Let's see if we can get this guy in two hits. And then move on towards the other guy. We can. That's so nice. One more here. Thank you so much. And there we go. That's two kills for Lurch. As expected, it's not that difficult to make that work. I hit with everything there. That was good. Oh, he's getting around us. Oh, good charge. It's an okay spot. We're fairly protected. Unfortunately, we did not hit and don't get a counterattack, but that's okay. Okay, Ovidio. You can't move through here. We could loot. Let's loot. Okay, they have nothing, so that was a waste. I keep forgetting that usually on the story missions they don't have any sort of significant gear. But yeah, looks like we're still close enough to get in here. But yeah, as I said, what I think this map is good in is wearing you down, because there will be reinforcements coming in early on, usually. As we can see here, probably as early as next turn already. Oh yeah, I don't have Frenzy on her, that's true. That was the other one. But yeah. We'll see, I guess. Right now, I think what else might be a problem is the close quarters fighting in the sewers. Because we need to go down there, and I still think take down, okay, they're all down there. A rat ogre? That's what this sounds like to me. Okay, we get hit there. And he's also warp poisoning us. That's kind of bad. He's gonna get counterattacks. Maybe this wasn't the smartest idea I ever had, but I hope it'll work out okay. We're dealing good damage here. Our strength is very high with this character. The enemy is not in any sort of armor, apparently. I need to check his resistances again, but at least to get a decent parry chance. We're in heavy armor. This should be okay, even with a poison. And we're dealing good damage here. And depending... I don't think we'll get another unit on there.
A new round not without started.
A lot of work. But I guess we'll see. Let's use her for scouting. There is a guy back there, a night runner. Let's check. This is still the entrance to the sewers, I assume. Okay, we don't see anything in there but one guy. And there's another guy down there. Yeah, we probably need to check this shipwreck. And it looks like the totem is right there. Probably. Okay, Shidi does not want to go in there alone. There's gonna be a rat ogre around that corner somewhere. I can't let her go in there first. She's too valuable for that. Which right now, well, let's check this with the leader here. Yeah, I could possibly climb up there, but I won't be able to jump down on the other side now, will I? No, it doesn't look like it, so we can't get another unit on there. I can also not climb up here. Yep, it's obstructed. Okay, let's go for the henchman. Not gonna kill it, though. I'm gonna delay. That way, ideally, Uncle Fester will get the kill. Perfect, we parried. That's one damage source taken care of. Okay, no counterattack. Or not a working one, at least. Yeah, and that's where things become problematic. Okay, he didn't get another attack, but we lose out on some as well. So we might not be able to kill him. Maybe Uncle Fester can actually get a Rotten Touch working up there. That seems like something he might be able to go for. No, we can't block the way down there, I think. I want Lurch first into the sewers. For somewhat obvious reasons. I'm just covering this area. Go for a little bit of area control. Okay, there's the Night Runner. He's got pistols and is in an Overwatch. But that's okay. That's something we can target now. Delay one more time. Can get Katarina over there and all the others. Let's see. So he's down. And now I just like... Apparently I cannot get the visual that I need. Now we can, okay. Let's go in there with some Rotten Touches. It's not a lot of damage, but it's a start. Gonna do both of them, actually. Ah, he resisted the second one, though. That's a bummer. Word light? What does that do? I'm just showing up on the map, I think. And being a general beacon to everything. Okay, got our stun recovery on him. Yeah, let's jump down here. I don't think we will get the Overwatch. Nope. Okay, I was considering if we can get him close enough. In theory, if I would have wanted to get hit by that, I think I would have. Because I didn't really want the other guys to be hit by that, but now Katarina's gonna get hit by that. There we go. Resisted the poison, at least. Well, it resisted one time. So I'm not quite sure how that plays out. Yeah, we're just gonna get... I need to charge in the end. Okay, charge from here. It's gonna cost me one attack, but that's okay. There's a Blackguard, or whatever they're called, back there. Who might... Warpguard. That's a Warpguard. It's Black Skaven and Warpguard, not Blackguard. That's gonna come this way. Oh, and there's one right left to us as well that I didn't notice. Okay, let's bring Bob down here. Okay, I need to be careful what to do with Katarina. Yeah, this is probably not gonna cover enough ground. We're not near enough to the ledge. So Benjamin needs to keep this safe. Yep, there is... No, isn't there? Oh, he's down there. Okay, that works. Yeah, but since we can reach here, we should... Yeah, okay, he's down there. So we see three enemies right now. Plus, we know there's a fourth one down the sewers. Probably they're impressive as well. And now we're gonna start taking a look here. Okay, he moved a little bit. I'd like to get charged. I assume the red ogre is around the corner here. We don't actually see anything yet. Ah, the totem is back there, isn't it? Maybe the red ogre will spawn once we take the totem? Or maybe he just isn't down here and the red ogre is somewhere on the docks back there. And we just need to gather the token out of the sewers to get rid of the fog. I don't know. But I'm going to move somebody else down here, and that person is going to pick that up. Or is that the totem? That might just be their card. Might be synonymous in this case, though. If the totem is just their warband sigil, it's not impossible, I guess. But we'll figure that one out as well. Now with the last hero dead, I think we might be looking at the first reinforcement spawning in. What is Zunda gonna do? Big questions. We probably want to go after the guy down here. Yeah, let's do that. Nope, we can't charge him. It's not surprising against Skaven that I'm not making any first impacts here, but I tried. At least I tried. That's all that matters. Well, in the end, success is what matters here, I guess, but a try is a good start. And maybe I should not keep her with her one arm, but I also don't really want to fire her just because of this setback. So I think I'm gonna try and make it work. Let's see if we can make this work, though. If he dodges once, we're not going to kill him this turn, and that makes it an issue, especially if this happens on top of everything. Our leader is in the worst spot right now, out of all of ours. I hope he can survive this and make this work. The Rotten Touches I feel very comfortable with right now. We're going to do another one next turn, and then way our leader probably only needs one more hit to get their leader. I hope it'll work out. Maybe we'll get a counterattack in there as well. It's a possibility. We'll see how it plays out. Okay, that's a miss, and I still have my parry. It's not a good parry, though, I think. No, okay, he's just getting one attack. Doesn't have two yet. A new only four round offense has points. Started. We could also move Katarina in there and maybe go for a Van Hell's Touch if we can get a visual on him, which we actually can. That's good. Let's heal up our leader a little bit. Gonna try and heal him twice, I think. Nice. Okay, that's 60 wounds. That should be enough to keep him alive. Still don't think I want to go down and in there. We're just gonna help out here once. There we go. That's a stun. I like this a lot. Okay, he failed his terror test. That is valuable. That's good. Gives him only one attack. Yeah, that worked. Okay, Benjamin. As I said, we wanted somebody else down here in the sewers. He can't do anything this turn yet. But next turn, he might be able to achieve something. We need to do something down here. And we have to see what. I need to just figure it out. And I'm gonna keep doing Rotten Touches up here. At least two. The third one is too risky for my taste, still. Overload? That's scary. Okay, that cost me all my offense points. I'm gonna keep Uncle Fester here first, for now. I should have parried as well. I think he's in a fairly safe state with this. Okay, that shouldn't be too bad. Psychological immunity and such. Can you do something this turn? Doesn't look like he can attack there, which means we're just gonna work our way towards those. And we need to get towards the ship anyways. Okay. Just an ambush? Bob, can you reach? Yes, you can. Well, maybe. No, we're... Wow, really? This is completely overlapping and blocking? That's not good. Okay, that means we need to... The alternative path there is also blocked. So I have to go with option C. Up this way. It's a big way around, but I hope it's worth it in the end. Yeah, we're not gonna attack there. That guy's stunned. He's not looking too good. I'm just... Yeah, we're going in here with Death Stench, helping ourselves out a bit. And then he's just not gonna do anything for this turn. Okay, terror test fail. Oh, why did he have to check now? That's weird. I think maybe we were... The game thought we were not in contact again. So, oh, there was a trap down there. So there's something down here. Oh, there it is. And there's the red ogre. Completed. Oh boy. And we're alone down in here. Aren't we?
New objectives added.
Gather objective the fog completed. Totem and get the red ogre in one process. But the way he's set up, I don't like that. Can we attack him from two sides? Can we also go this way? I think we should be able to. Which means for now I'm going to go into an ambush stance right here. And I'm going to try and bring somebody else down there. And then we'll take that thing on in with two units at the same time. Good. That's awesome. Good stun. Let's hit him one more time. That was very valuable. We need to kill the guy down there, though. Let's see if you can do that. He's stunned. So as long as you deal critical damage, it should be doable. Or not, just not minimal damage. How about that? Yep, yep. As expected. Really? Ah, that's a bummer. But he's gonna get his turn, I think, still. And that means... Come on, please. Just let me kill this one. Thank you. Okay, good. And we'll bring our leader down in here. I guess. Yeah, we have three units down here. That should be good enough, but I'm not gonna risk an ambush right there. In case the red ogre decides to run this way, we would block ourselves with this, and I don't think that's a good idea. Our guy in front, the ghoul, might already be in an ambush stance as well. So that could backfire anyways. Let's see what he gets. Makes his all alone check. Fails his fear test, so his hit chance is bad. And there we go.
A new round has started.
Okay, one down. I don't think I want to bring in her as well. We have three units against their impressive now. That needs to be enough. That's cool. You can look over there. You actually see them in there. I like that. We are gonna help out with this shingding. Starting right there. I would have liked to heal our leader one more time because he's still not full, and against the impressive that scares me a bit. But in the end, it's still okay. Yeah, we're just gonna kill him. I could have delayed there, gotten the kill on somebody else, but I'm okay with that. It's just one experience. I know it adds on to more over time. She's just the second or third guy she's already taken out, but I'm still okay with that. I don't want to do this like that. I think what he's gonna do right now is go for this wordstone here. Yeah, why not? That bag is the enemy. Isn't it? Yeah, like this. There's another. That's a cluster. I think I'm just gonna go for their cart. Okay, the red ogre is still just there. Cluster, charge. Okay, just like this. And then our leader can circle back here and go for the rest. And the thing we need to loot is back there anyways. We should have enough room to get all three guys on there. I hope. At least that's what it feels like right now. I'd like to go down there with Uncle Fester as well, but I think that's not the right call. That's too risky. We are gonna bring him in here and try to... Yeah, we can. That's good. Deal a little bit of damage. So far, this mission has been going okay. It's three. The three parts are the big questions right now. If there's something... Still a surprise waiting for us that we don't expect. Right now, I don't see it. But I assume something will still happen. So we need to locate the barge and the shipwreck. The barge is probably... It's gonna be over here. But the shipwreck is this, I guess? So I'm just putting myself right here. And we are split up right now. And that's something that I wouldn't need to do necessarily, I think. But I want to do just to make better progress. And it makes for a better pace. And it's also working right now as well.
New objectives added.
Okay.
Objective completed.
So what did we find out? We located the barge. Okay, so it's the floating thing. Yeah, I remember what a barge is. So we need to go straight and then left. So we place the Raven officer's coffins and the High Commander's coffins and the Martyr's coffins or sarcophagus. And then over there is the shipwreck. We already see something to loot there. Do we locate any enemies? We do not. So I'm just going to do this. And now having everything on Katarina should work out as I had planned it, or hope it would work out. Can I? No, we can't. Because she's got a good movement range, and she alone needs to be on the barge to really do something. And yeah, I feel very confident right now. The only problem standing in our way, as far as I can tell at this point in time, is the Red Ogre. That could still wreck us, because I'm going in there with good units, but that could still backfire if we get critted badly or something like that. I assume it won't, but we'll see how it'll turn out in the end. I mean, we're basically finding out any minute now. It's not like we are very much away. I don't see any issues with enemies back there, so I think just to be on the safe side, I'm gonna move Zunda towards the sewer. She's got a good movement range and can predictably make it into combat, I think, next turn, in case something does go wrong. So a little bit of a fail-safe there for our part. Let's see about that Rat Ogre. He's probably gonna charge us. No, I get the charge on him. I'm gonna take that. We hit him for 68. 62 back. Okay, let's see. Every hit is of note here. He doesn't have a chance to crit us either. At least our impressive. That helps. But our hit points are what concerns me here. Okay. I'm still gonna move in Michal. I hope he can actually make it there. Oh, and he won't be able to parry if he does. He can't make it there. Oh, no. Well, now this becomes interesting and scary all at once. I thought I could get him there. I underestimated the range of that again. A miss. It's not even a dodge. It's a miss. Okay. Didn't dodge, but he missed once. I hope that means we can survive one round of his attacks. I think he shouldn't get more. Okay. Oh, God. Yep. Now we're at the point where it gets scary, because we need for the Red Ogre to die this turn. And I also overestimated the range our Vampire Thrall could run, because she definitely cannot get there in time. But yeah. I'll have to figure something out here. So how do we get down to the barge? Apparently I'll have to leap. Right there. Maybe there would also be some way of going down, but... yeah, we just don't see any enemies right now, so that's okay. And I'm gonna leap down there next turn. Okay, Benjamin might... The only thing he might need to do is... get rid of the dodge of this thing. Oh good, I can actually make it past this. I hope this means that our leader can also still get on there. But everything I needed here was for him to lose his dodge now. That lurch can deal the big damage. This is scary as hell, though. I don't like this one bit. Yeah, let's go check out the shipwreck. Okay, we do see this. Yeah, they are right there, so I don't need to climb up there or anything. I think with the sisters, I needed to do that. Oh god, he's gotten a lot of backlash today. David, you are right there.
New objectives nice. Added. Objective complete.
Both dang coffins.
New objectives added.
And do I need to place those? Of course we need to place those as well. Okay, he's a bit slow. It's gonna take a bit. And I have nothing else to do, which means we are gonna move towards... Wait, where was he? Where are you? Oh, you're all the way here. I'm gonna move back towards the sewer, I think. Is that the right way to go? I don't think so. I think up here is actually better. I can, jump down then. Just in case. The Red Ogre is the only thing left to us, but the Red Ogre is a lot hotter than I assumed he would be. And I miscalculated the distances a bit. That cost us an entire round of damage being dealt to it. So I have to assume that we might have to bring in reinforcements. I don't hope it'll come to that, but it might be, and I just want to be want to make sure. And there's also the reinforcements that are coming in from somewhere that could become an issue sooner or later. There we go. We've got a zombie right there as well, so at least this guy we should be able to deal with, but this is what I meant. Now, there's gonna be reinforcements coming in from multiple sides that I will have to just take care of somehow. And that could lead to at least the loss of one unit if I'm not careful. Because we can't quite say where they're gonna come from. No, let's not go this way. Let's go straight, because if Lurch goes down, it frees up a spot on that side. While everything is already occupied on the other side anyway. So next turn, we can bring her in if need be. I hope it won't be needed. Yeah, we cannot disengage. As you might expect, I need to hit with basically everything, and even then we won't be able to kill him. I think... Ah, crap. Missed. Our leader really needs to do a good job, and he might not be able to attack. I think Lurch might go down. Yeah, it looks pretty likely right now. Don't have sidestep yet to allow me to avoid two attacks. It's pretty likely that that's gonna backfire right now. Okay, got the charge there. Now we've got a few one-on-one scenarios here that we need to take care of. Usually the reinforcements aren't very hard to kill. Their weaponry is normal, and they just feel squishier than some of the other ones, but we'll see. Okay, can get somebody else in there. I could charge, but 65 is not good, so I'm gonna take the 75. It didn't matter in this case. And at least now he has some units to choose from, but I assume he's still gonna focus on the guy that is weakest right now. And he can just bypass my parry, I believe. But I'm still gonna go for it because he's got dodge bypass anyway, so that would be 0%. It doesn't matter. That's what I'm trying to say. Let's see what he does. Yes, he goes for him. That's okay right now. Ah, we survived. The dodge failed, but we survived. And now I'm toast. Well, as expected, unfortunately. Let's hope that nothing bad comes out of this. That wasn't nice, but it was my own fault. Could have ended this better. Yeah, place Raven officers' coffins, all three of them, luckily.
Objective completed.
Do I need to get the fog totem on there as well? I hope not. This
objective
one.
Completed.
I don't think so. It looks like I just need to get the sarcophagi, or the coffins and the sarcophagus on there. Actually running through
objective
all the right spaces
completed.
Right now. So we just have the one thing left here. Yeah, place the dank coffins. There we go. Can actually heal back there. Might as well. If I had brought her in there as well, it would have been better against the Rat Ogre, but it's too late now. It's... yeah, it's too late now. Let's just accept responsibility and make do with what we have. And the important thing is that we kill the Rat Ogre before he now kills our entire group down there. As long as our leader hits with at least two of his attacks, that should be doable, but it'll still be somewhat difficult. Maybe. I don't know. We also have our vampire thrall that can still do stuff. We'll see how it'll turn out. I really can't say. It's kind of a... It's all dependent on what the RNG decides to give me in the end. And this is probably what's going to take the longest, because he can't get there this turn, and he probably can't get there next turn. If he gets minus movement now, it's even worse. I hope he gets the opposite, though. Nope, was a negative warp effect. Okay, that's pretty meaningless for that. But, I mean, we also have these guys, too, to humor ourselves with. Pass the time, doing something reasonable, and getting maybe another XP or two out of the deal. But we'll see, I guess. Very, very soon. At least they are failing all of their dodges, but that's pretty much what I mean. I think the reinforcements aren't the same level as the usual units on the map, because it might be too difficult if that would be the case. Yes, I know I should have Death Stench first, but as always, as per course, you know what you're getting here. I keep forgetting about it. Forget about it. And that was so bad. Bob's also not looking too healthy, but if that's only one attack, it's still gonna take two or three more turns for that one Skaven to really do anything to us. But there's more reinforcements coming. And this is where things become dangerous. Because it keeps splitting me up more and more and more. We just need to get the kill. Okay, you will go over here. And not go down towards the... Towards the totem down there and whatever. It's too far. He's not gonna get there. He's too slow. But that was one more experience. Zanda can not go for the totem yet, unfortunately. Now I'm gonna charge. 75 is good enough for my taste, and she has two more attacks afterwards. Come on. This is looking good. All we need is 80 more damage. Okay, perfect. That is...
objective completed.
Very good. Yeah, let's just go back towards this. Okay, nice. We can make it exactly. Pick up all of these. At least we're getting good wordstone out of this as well. It's... I just hope that Lurch is okay. That he's gonna make a full recovery and not be dead or lose an arm or something like that. On an impressive... that would be... not fun to deal with. He actually had something decent to take. Nice. I assume we can't loot this. Yes, we cannot. Which for me means we're just gonna let the ghoul do that, and I hope that he's gonna... Oh, there's a second entrance, actually. Where is that leading? Okay, they're up there. Okay, let's cover this. It's also okay. I wasn't aware of this one, to be honest. Let's just hope that we don't have to put that totem on there as well. I don't think so. It looks like there's just one more spot here. And that's going to be the end. And I hope that turns out to be the case. But yeah, he's still not going to make it there this turn. I'll need one more. Let's just cover this area. Okay, we'll find out now. Inventory is full. Oh, God. Well, she over there still has one inventory slot. Yeah, I forgot that I filled him up. That's smart. So let's move him over here. At least we know there's an alternative exit here that's closer to where we need to be. There is an enemy still alive up here. Yep, there he is. When we could maybe kill him. Ah, he dodged. If we've gotten that hit. Uncle Fester is one of the ones that needs the experience the most here. Didn't quite work out. That's a bummer. Okay, David. He can never reach that this turn. Next turn, though. Next turn, he's in there. So his turn might mark... Come on. Might mark the end of things. It's actually not as long as I anticipated it to be. They rushed us a little bit, but not nearly enough for it to become super dangerous. And that allowed us to plow through this pretty quickly and efficiently. At least for right now. I don't know. If the reinforcements could still annoy us, losing the one guy is certainly not good. But once again, I hope he's gonna be okay. But we'll see. We might still have to do some more running around. If it turns out that the totem needs to be on the barge as well. I still don't think so. I think it's gonna end. But we'll see. Yeah, I'm just gonna... We're just gonna not move, we're gonna ambush, keep everybody where he is. So, as to not delay this any longer, as need be. Hey, there's one. Oh no. Okay, he fell down. That might prevent that. No, he's climbing up again. Ah, I thought he would save up there. Please don't kill him. Okay, he missed. He's gonna get a second attack, though. He's only carrying a one-handed weapon. But only 19 damage. It's not that bad. Could be way worse. Is there another guy that's gonna come up there? Yeah, of course. Oh boy, really? Oh good, only one. Now this is what I meant. This is it's a problem. It's a big problem. Well, not really, but it's dangerous about this map, because in a lot of areas you don't have a lot of visibility. It's very secluded, and that makes it easy for the reinforcements to really hurt you. Her inventory was good, wasn't it? Yes, okay. And I need to sneeze, one moment. And we're back. You didn't hear that. I paused in time. Look at that, Skaven Fog Totem.
New objectives added.
Oh no, added?
Objective completed.
Place the Fog Totem on the barge. Ah, as if I hadn't known. Of course, we need to do that. So now, I need to keep everybody alive long enough. At least we see what we come out here. Ah, come on. So there is a way to do this a lot more controlled. So everybody goes into the sewers first, then you move out of there in force and go over here. But as we all know, that's not what I did. So now I'll have to try and survive up there, or have the one ghoul survive. Which seems rather unlikely, I think. It's not gonna happen.
A new round has started.
The game took some time there to figure out what it needed to do. Can I climb up there maybe? No. I can heal though. That's good. I can try and get two heals up in there. Heal him up by 60. Nice, okay. That might allow us to keep him alive, depending on whether or not they're gonna attack him. And we can also go with Dance with the... Wait, what does that do? Grants me to all... Oh no, okay, that does not help us. What does Call of Van Hill on others do? For vampires, vampire throughout schools. Okay, initiative and dodge chance. Yeah, that seems reasonable. So we're gonna call off Van Hel him as well. There we go. That's probably the best we can do for him. Okay, Benjamin. Just help out here, buddy. Don't think it's gonna matter that much. There's apparently no reinforcements coming this way. I think there are some that are starting basically north from us there. But they're not quite showing up, or they're just moving in a different pattern than I expect them to. So we can't, once again, reach them here, I think. Let's try if we can maybe climb and jump down somewhere and reach it like that. But it does not look like it right now. This actually allows it, yes. But I have no movement points left, so if I'm not in combat already, I will not be this turn. Yep. I can Rotten Touch at least. Can hit that one. That would have been better if we had one point left over. Oh, come on. I'm gonna ambush Stance. I'm not gonna risk more. Okay, David, you need to put the dank. Yeah, okay, of course. Now the last thing shows up. But only after I've found the totem.
Objective complete.
Makes sense. Okay. Only one thing missing. And I might... Oh, there's reinforcements down there. Okay. Maybe I'll pause this depending on how it's gonna continue from now on. But we do have more fights going around here. I'm just trying to play this down as quickly and efficiently as possible. So that it's not just all filler that you need to watch here. We'll see how far I can get with her this turn as well. I'm focusing on him right now because he's got less hit points. So once we kill him, the other one will have to check for all alone. And that's just gonna make it a lot safer for Bob here. He's still not in the best spot ever. And I doubt he will die this turn. I don't think they can deal enough damage to him for that to matter. But it's checking the right boxes, so being safe, better safe than sorry. I thought he would be safe there, but I should have probably kept him in an open spot so that he would be easier to defend. Now we're in close quarters and I have to try and keep him alive the hard way. It was the wrong call there. But I'm very annoyed with all these reinforcements, but it just highlights perfectly what I think the strengths of this map is, because it's taking forever for me right now. It's my own fault because I tackled the mission. I tried to be efficient about it, but in the end, now it makes things more difficult for me. Because if you go into the sewer first with everybody, or almost everybody, and then move out in one coherent group again, it should be a lot easier. I split up to try and cover a lot of ground quickly and make all the objectives happen somewhat simultaneously, but the mission does not allow for that. I couldn't have known that going in, I think. Doesn't change the fact that that's what would happen here. As long as we keep control of the situation, it's fine. It's no problem. And now we've regained control of the situation, in my opinion. But I think it still shows very well why why this mission can be troublesome. Yeah, let's just see how far you can get. Oh, good thing that we do have some movement increases on them already. This is still taking forever, even with their movement range again having a decent... I think I've mastered armor proficiency and we have knowledge more time on them as well. Yeah, hit this one. So hopefully next turn we can get the totem on there, and that's gonna end the mission at that point. Right now, this is good, because we get experience from killing reinforcement. They still count as units. So it's more experience in total for us. And Lurch is dead regardless of what I do, or not dead, he's down for this mission regardless of what I do.
A new round has started.
And we'll just have to wait and see how this plays out in the long run. Let's just add on here. I'm not gonna kill him, or try to kill him at least. We're just softening up a bit so that the zombie can finish the job. And then, of course, I crit. Because why wouldn't I? Okay. I hope it's not gonna come to us killing that guy, because that would mean that I would not have reached the barge, which we hopefully will be able to do. But it's, once again, checking all the boxes, better safe than sorry, just... having all of our priorities straight, we should assume that this will keep going. So I need to make sure that we make the right decisions here. And he's still in a dangerous spot. He might still die. In hindsight, maybe I should have disconnected there. Try and get him away. I didn't. But our necromancer, Uncle Fester, will also go first, which will force the other guy to check for all alone. So we are, I think, still okay there. That's at least my hope. He might die now, but that's our best chance to really prevent that, I guess. With a lot of luck, we might also kill him. I doubt it. Not without this. Yeah, not without a crit. It's not happening. He's almost dead, but not quite. What are you gonna do? You're just moving out of the way, I guess. Bring him up here. Okay, who's up next? Oh? But he's looting? What did he loot? Oh, it's a new guy. Oh, no. Ah, crap. Yeah, the ghoul is gonna go down. Oh no. Where are you? You're... Can you get in there? He actually can. Okay. This is very solid. It's the group up there. That's dangerous. I did not expect another guy to show up there. That was a mistake. Let's just not bother with that. Yeah, he's gonna go down now. There we go. Ah, would have gone for all alone if that guy hadn't shown up. That's... Ah, don't like that. At least these guys are failing everything. So there's that. But yeah. That's not good. Not what we were expecting. I just did not think this through. That was something that I missed. Should have expected another reinforcement to show up. I should have blocked this hallway. Our setup now is amazing. With everything of these, we will be able to kill 4 more reinforcements if we really want to. But only if she doesn't make it there now, because I don't want to delay this any longer. I think she's going to be able to get there. I could delay this for one turn. We have nobody else who's in danger of dying, and she actually can make it there. So next turn is going to be the end here. So we actually get our kills. And let's just try to make them quickly and efficiently. Would have liked for him to get both of them, but with him missing one attack, that's not gonna happen. Okay. Those end of turns take longer and longer because I assume he's gonna try to figure out if he needs to send more reinforcements in, or how many, or what kind of, something along those lines. These are annoying, but not too bad, I think. I'm gonna go up there and maybe... I would have liked to go with Lifestealer, but that would kill the one up there. You know what, let's just end our turn. Let's try to play this quick. I think this mission, I made it harder on myself than it needed to be. I made some errors here that cost me pretty big. Nice. Should have actually just charged there, because it was an automatic hit anyways. I forgot about him being stunned again. But it's still okay. Oh wow, really? Where are you coming from? Is there... there might be a reinforcement spawn point in this building. That's what it feels like right now. Yeah, as I've said, I'm just gonna... We're gonna try and just stick to the essentials now. And the essentials don't include us dealing damage there. Or moving there. Because we're gonna end this with our Vampire Thrall anyways. And we have nobody in danger of dying right away, I think. We just have one more chance to kill somebody before this is over. But then we're gonna end it. Yep. He can, if he makes one hit here, there we go. And that's it. I assume. And now somebody big and bad is gonna spawn. Hopefully not. And I'm gonna regret my words, but let's just assume that that's not the case, shall we?
Objective completed.
Okay. Yeah, 18 enemies out of action. 2 of ours. Let's just hope that nothing bad happens there.
So utterly despicable that there isn't even a sense of satisfaction in destroying them. Even the blood of Skaven is vile. A black swill that stinks of all things foul. Count Vlad will need to make provision in his plans for attending to these vermin. Completed. Too often have they meddled in the affairs of their betters. Perhaps before conquering the Empire of Men, it will be necessary to exterminate the kingdoms of rats first. The ratkin you killed this day are but a drop in a sea of vermin. But if it isn't possible to kill them all, it is possible to fill their craven hearts with fear. It will take some effort on the part of their leaders to make the Skaven poke their noses into the Quayside for some time. Though it seems a defilement of the necromantic arts, I am tempted to send some of their dead companions back to them as zombies. That should see them truly cowering in their holes. The corpses you sent to Sylvania will be of great utility to Count Vlad. It is a simple enough thing to raise legions of mindless soldiers, but the commanders of those legions must be selected with greater care. They must have been leaders in life before they can be leaders in undeath. The spells to reanimate such officers are more refined than those that raise packs of zombies and skeletons, for some of the spirit must be restored along with the body. Only then is there that spark of initiative that endows the undead with any degree of versatility. Count Vlad will need many more before he has his cadre to lead his legions. What you have given the master is a start, and a beginning for which you will not go unrewarded. Just as the master needs the corpses of heroes, so too will he need more Weirdstone. With the Skaven routed, your hunt should be less arduous for a time. Make the most of the respite.
And there we go. Let's see about the aftermath. Wow, 4 enemies out of action for Ovidio. That's insane.
Fantastic. We've
got some light wounds, a full recovery on Bob, and hitting rank 7. Benjamin.
Fantastic.
There we go. And a full recovery on Lurch. Thank you so much.
The gods.
And he ranked up as well. Up to 7.
Fantastic.
Uncle Fester is finally rank 5.
Is getting
and
stronger.
Our warband hit rank 7. That's cool. And that also means that we have one more slot here. I'm going to wait for the rewards out of this mission, because I think at the end of the first act, which we now are at, you usually always get a henchman, or not a henchman, a hero as a reward. And that way we can bring that hero in. If it's a vampire thrall, I'm not going to go for her, because we already have to. But I just hope it's going to be somebody different. Otherwise, we might go for a DLC unit after all. But we'll see. We'll see. But yeah, that was the last story mission of Act 1. And I liked it. I like the Quayside map. It's nothing extraordinary, but I like the way it's set up. And this mission was not bad, I think. It was one of the more normal ones, basically. I'm very happy with the full recoveries, of course. So there's that as well. And we will move on from there. So thank you all very much for watching today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like and a comment. And if you want to see me play more time, just stick around. And as always, thanks for watching. I hope that you will tune in next time. And have a nice day. Bye.